Hi, my name is Jeroen. I'm a developer at Enrise, a self-steering agency in the Netherlands. I always like to experiment with new techniques and tools, especially when they can be automated to improve my workflow. One of these techniques is called mutation testing, and today I would like to give you an introduction to mutation testing with PHP. I will start by explaining what mutation testing is. Have you ever wondered, is this test adding any value? Does this test really cover everything? Or how safely can I refactor this code? PHP units can tell you how much code coverage you have, but this code coverage is a measurement of the percentage of lines executed during the test. This means that as long as a line is executed and it does not throw any error, it will increase the coverage metric, even if it contains unintended logic, because humans make mistakes. So with the current code coverage, what we have is the amount of code executed during tests, but what we want is the amount of faults caught during tests. With just this one assertion, for example, every line inside the isShippingV function would be executed, and thus the line coverage would be 100%. However, we did not test for exactly 35, and neither did we find a bug that occurs since there is no return statement for prices over 35. The line coverage is basically misleading us, or possibly even giving a false confidence. So except for code reviews from fellow colleagues, how do we know when there are tests missing? Well, mutation testing can help you to measure the effectiveness of your tests. This is how it works. You take one line of code and you change one little thing to create a bug in the logic. This is called a mutant. Next, you run the test and you see what happens. If the tests fail, they are effective since they found and killed the mutant. If the tests succeed, you are missing tests or assertions because the mutant has escaped. With the general concepts covered, let's now take a look at mutation testing in PHP. For this, I use the infection PHP library. It is actively developed, it can generate a lot of mutants, and it is easy to run. Infection PHP can be installed in many ways, for example, standalone for your whole project or just a single file. But the most powerful use, however, will be through some form of automated integration with your workflow. I recently created an open source Elasticsearch driver for Lago Scout called Explorer. And in there, I have an auto review GitHub action that I use for pull requests. In that GitHub action, I am using the built-in logger of infection PHP to leave escape mutants as annotations in the pull requests, as you can see in the screenshot. I believe that as automated feedback, this is a great way to maintain an effective test suite over time and strengthen code reviews between team members. Infection PHP has a lot of mutators divided over about 18 profiles, or sets of mutators. A single mutator is, for example, changing the visibility of a public function, and a profile might be small, such as the return value, or very large, such as the default profile. Depending on the age and the size of your code base and your test suite, I would recommend to start with a few mutants, or maybe just a default profile, and as you grow your test suite, you might find yourself building up your own collection of mutators. If you run it as part of your continuous integration, you could tell Infection PHP that all new code should have a given minimum amount of killed mutants in order to pass, and thus continuously improving your confidence in the tests. Let's now take a look at a code sample and some mutants. Here's a function that determines if a product should be shipped for free or not. If the product is priced lower than or equal to 35, shipping is never free. If a product is priced over 35, the shipping is free if a coupon is assigned and if the shipment carrier accepts free shipping. There are a few possible mutants that could be introduced in this function. Let's take a look at three options. Each of these mutants would change the code on the fly after which the tests are executed. If the tests are effective, they should fail and thus kill the mutants. First, I might, for example, change the function signature from public to private. If no test is calling this method at all, the mutant would escape. And if this mutant escaped, you might ask yourself if this function is used or tested at all. Secondly, I could slightly alter the conditional. So originally, if the price was exactly 35, you could never get free shipping. I should have a test that makes sure that the function returns false given a price of exactly 35. And thirdly, I could just flip the return value from false to true. For PHP unit, it is enough for this function to be called to include it in the covered code. And this mutant will try to see if the test actually verifies the result of the function before considering its covered code. When you run Infection PHP, the tool will give you three measurements that can give you a feeling about the effectiveness of your code compared to the line coverage from PHP unit. The first measurement is the mutation score indicator, or how many mutants did you find. I would argue that this is the most important measurement because it tells you how effective your tests are at testing your code. The higher the MSI, the more confidence you can have your test that they would warn you if you happen to introduce a bug. The second measurement is the mutation covered code. And this measurement is more or less the same as PHP unit's overall code coverage. You are doing a great job if the MSI is close to this percentage. The last measurement that Infection PHP gives you is similar to the regular MSI, but this one leaves out your uncovered code, whereas the MSI would include mutants in non-tested code as well. The covered code mutation score indicator should go up and become closer to the MSI as you write more tests. Now let's put mutation testing in practice with the example of the shipping fee calculator. Let me switch over to PHP Storm. The codebase consists of the shipping calculator class that just has the single function from the example. Besides that, I also have a product class that only defines the price and the shipping coupon. And I have a simplified carrier class that only defines if it should accept free shipments. This file right here is the configuration file for Infection PHP. As I mentioned before, there are a lot of different options, but I kept it small and simple for now. And these are the three things you would need to define. They are the location of the source files that are the subject of the test, the type and the destination of the logs in case mutants are found or escaped. I set it to a text file to get very detailed results. And lastly, here you should define the mutants you want Infection PHP to let loose on your code. You may define individual mutants or profiles like I am doing here with the default profile. I already wrote one test for the shipping calculator. As you can see right now, I'm only testing a product with a low price and no coupon. Obviously, the shipping free function should return false here. I already wrote this test because Infection PHP expects a passing test suite before it begins with the mutations. And as you might imagine, having no test is not a passing test suite. I will now open my terminal and we will run PHP unit with the coverage as text. And this one test I already wrote already provides me with 66% coverage according to PHP unit. So now let's run Infection PHP. As you can see right here, Infection PHP tried out 10 mutations, but only 3 mutants got killed. Since we killed 3 out of a total of 10 mutants, that gives us a mutation score indicator of 30%. Not all mutants occurred in code that was covered by the test, only half to be precise. So that gives it a code coverage of 50%. So 5 out of 10. Note how this is already 60% lower than the line coverage reported by a PHP unit. If we zoom in and only focus on those 5 mutants that were covered by the test, then 3 out of the 5 were killed. And that gives us the code, covered codes MSI of 60%. Let's switch back to PHP Storm and have a look at the mutants that escaped. They can be found inside the infection.log file. And just like the example I provided earlier, the first two mutants targeted the conditional of the isShippingFee function. So I should have write a test that verifies that a price of exactly 35 is not sufficient for free shipping. If I scroll further down, we will find a section with the mutants that were not covered by the test. And these first two mutants escaped with changing the function signature from public to protected. This should be solved by writing a test for a product with a high price and a coupon and verifying that it is sufficient for free shipping. Because right now, these two methods, allow free shipping and has free shipping coupon, are not being called during the test suite. I believe this will also cover the next mutant. Although I could also write a separate test case for the product class to make this more explicit. The last two mutants you see right now also escape because I have not yet written a test about a product with a coupon. So let's add these tests right now. First, I go back to the shipping calculator test. The first test that I will add is this one. Let me uncomment it first. It will test that a product with a coupon and a price of exactly 35 may not be shipped for free. So let's immediately switch to the terminal and see the impact of adding this one test. First, I will run PHP unit. Interestingly, PHP unit has no change in the coverage, but at least all the tests are passing. Infection will... nice. Infection does have some changes. We no longer have any uncovered mutants, so the covered MSI is at 100%. All mutants occur in code that is executed by the tests. Unfortunately, only half of them is being killed. So it's time for more tests. Let's get back to PHP Storm. I will uncomment the next test. This one will test that a product with a high price and a coupon is actually getting free shipping. The test after that is testing for a product with a high price with no coupon, so there should be no free shipping. And lastly, there should be a test that even if a product has a high price and it has a coupon, if the carrier is not accepting free shipments, there should be no free shipping for this product. Let's go to the terminal and run PHP unit and see what happens. Great, all tests pass and the coverage is all green as well. Now for infection PHP. Great, all mutants are killed. So we now have a mutation score indicator for this one test at 100%. And I hope this gives you a feeling of how you could use mutation testing to improve your tests. I also want to show you how quickly you can get started with mutation testing in a Laravel application. For this example, I have created a fresh new Laravel application with the Jetstream Starter Kit. The great thing is that it also ships with tests, but I want to find out how effective they are right now. So let's go back to PHP Storm. The only thing I had to change about the infection PHP configuration file was changing the location of the source files to app. I am going to focus on only one action that the package gives you, and that's the create new user action you see right here. It's not very complex, it validates the input and hopefully returns a newly created user. Let's run infection PHP for just this file. As you can see, I use the filter option to scope the mutation testing to just one file from the whole code base. InfectionPHP now has found 6 mutants, of which only 2 were killed. Let's try to improve that right now. Switching back to PHP Storm again, I found that the registration test is the one that belongs to the create new user action. And right now, the registration test only tests the happy flow. So a full set of input with a should return a authenticated user and gets redirected to the dashboard page. If I open the infection log file, you can see that we have a new mutant. This one is called array item removal, and it removes elements from arrays, as the name already implies. In this case, the name element of the validator array. And as you can see, the name should be required, but we did not have a test to verify this. And the same goes for the email address. So let's switch back to the registration test. And I will uncomment these two tests I had written before. They are quite straightforward tests. They will verify that indeed without a name or without an email address, you will not be authenticated, but instead you will get redirected away from the dashboard. When I run infection.php again, and again for this file only, we will see the new results and they will look pretty hopeful. Yeah, we now have killed all 6 mutants and we are basically done for the create new user action. I could move on to the next file or the next mutant. I hope this will help you to get started with mutation testing in your own existing or new LAV application very fast. If after this talk you would like to get started, be sure to check out the documentation of InfectionPHP. You can fiddle with some code and different mutators at the playground at infectionphp.dev. If you would like to talk about things like testing or automation in general, you're welcome to come by the Enterprise booth where I and my colleagues are hanging out. Wrapping it up, I would suggest you install InfectionPHP to get started with mutation testing, but only with just the default mutant set to get a feeling of how it can help you and to prevent getting overwhelmed by the amount of mutants that escaped. My advice will be to remember that 100% scores are not the main objective. Mutation testing should help you to improve your confidence in your tests and your code base, one step at a time. That's all for now. Thank you for listening and have fun testing.